best underfills you can buy. And one of the main reasons why it's been regarded as the best is its battery life. It is the best that Huawei offers right now, and obviously it costs a lot. But what if you can get the same battery performance on the Mate 20 Pro for just $200? Out comes the new Huawei Y7 Prime 2019 variant. If you guys remember, the last year's model was incredibly popular on the channel, so I want you to check out the 2019 variant. I've been using it for some time, and first thing I can say is that this thing is really incredible when it comes to battery life. Nearly 10 hours of screen on time on a really heavy usage, playing Asphalt 9, YouTube, Instagram, which is almost the same stats I get on my Huawei Mate 20 Pro. This year, a lot of super budget phones will come out with bigger battery sizes, and Huawei is doing just that. Apart from this great battery, let's talk about what else this phone is offering for this $200 price. First on the list is the build quality and design. Looking at this phone, it reminds me a lot about the Huawei P20. We've got all the essentials like the fingerprint scanner, dual camera on the back, a really shiny color shifting back, which is actually made up of plastic. I mean, the finish is so good that you can say that it's almost like a gloss phone, but it is actually a plastic back. Obviously, for a $200 price point, I think the build quality is on point. Sitting over to the front of the phone, we've got a 6.2-inch display that is having a resolution of 720p. It's a decent bright panel for indoor usage, definitely not as bright in the outdoor situations, but again, for the price of $200, it's hard to complain. I mean, a 294 ppi 720p HD display is enough in my opinion. Obviously, if you put this display side by side against the expensive phone, you will see the differences. But most people who are looking to buy a $200 phone won't be noticing the differences that much. However, I would definitely appreciate an AMOLED panel, but LCD it is, and I just like the latest trend we've got is the notch up front. A really small notch is actually a lot smaller than the Huawei Mate 20 Pro. Then, of course, we have a chin at the bottom as well that has a Huawei logo. I mean, we have the logo on the back. We know it's your phone. You don't have to put a chin up front, but that's what they did. Now, a 720p display might not be that high-end, but it does allow this phone to reach incredible battery performance. It comes with Qualcomm Snapdragon 450 processor with 3GB of RAM. If you look at the product specification for this chipset, on their website, it literally says that it's built for battery efficiency. It is one of the top features of this chip. Combined with the 4000mAh battery size, a 720p display, it allows this phone to go to that Mate 20 Pro battery level, or maybe even higher, depending on your usage. I was playing Asphalt 9 using YouTube and Instagram, having that high usage, and it really did impress me. So if you have a battery preference, you want one day of usage, then this phone definitely does give you that comfortably. But of course, there are things like no fast charging, and of course, the limitations of this chipset. I mean, it is pretty efficient, but it doesn't provide you that full power that you might find on other chipsets like Snapdragon 660. So, especially the high-end gamer folks who want to game a lot on their phone, this definitely does struggle in that department. I mean, it can run games like Asphalt 9, as you can see, but it definitely isn't looking all that great as far as the FPS and performance is concerned. But daily day-to-day usage, like browsing the web and using Instagram and WhatsApp, all that stuff works absolutely fine, and RAM management is also very decent. It's only 3GB of RAM, but still, it does keep up the applications. If you open like 5-4 apps, you should be able to keep those in the memory without any refresh. Now, it comes with Android 8.1 Oreo, slightly disappointing because it's not the latest version of the Android, which is the 9.05. Hopefully, you might see the update in the future. I'm actually rocking the Nova Launcher because I'm not a huge fan of the EMUI. Obviously, they did huge improvements with the 9.05 version, but since it's the Oreo version, I'm just having the Nova Launcher. I do like some UI elements such as the dark notification panel. I like the way how settings look. It does have useful features such as the one-handed mode and also the ability to take screenshots by swiping 3 fingers across the display is really cool as well. It comes with 32 gigs of memory, and along with that, it also offers the support for SD card tray, so you could expand the story if you want to. And finally, let's talk about those $200 dual cameras on the back. So we have a 30-megapixel sensor along with a 2-megapixel depth sensor, while on the front it rocks a 16 megapixel selfie snapper, which is actually really decent. Take some sharp selfies, you don't have to worry about that potential quality. As far as the results with the back camera is concerned, it's doing a decent job as long as you are in a good lighting. The pictures do come out flat and it has less details and less saturation, but a bit of editing in the BS Express app for Android, you can definitely take some good photos. And for the price, I would say it is actually a decent camera. Again, you can't expect too much in low light situations. You will see a lot of noise and also in nighttime situations. For the video performance, it shoots 1080p, and it also looks a lot grainy if you're shooting in dark or low light conditions. So what's the verdict of this phone? If you're someone who's looking for a cheap Android phone, but you want to have a flagship grade battery performance, then this might be the phone to go for. Other than that, I like the build quality. The display is decent, could have been better, and thankfully the camera doesn't shoot potential pictures, so it does a decent job with that as well. It's hard to argue in this price point, but by far the best thing that attracted me about this phone is its battery performance. So again, let me know your thoughts about this in the comment section below. It's been a while since I've reviewed a really budget phone, which I used to do before, but yeah, these videos are coming back. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for daily tech videos, and I'll see you guys in the next one.